we first started, we were very, a lot of people were surprised we were very passive people, very average, you know, fairly pleasant people. And then when we got on stage, it was like chaos. Like, it was just like anarchy. And for us, I know it was just always a situation where, like, we were very responsible people, you know, good family lives, we were students and, you know, we had jobs and everything like that. I was working, like, a corporate job and stuff like that. And this was our opportunity for that half hour, an hour we were on stage to just not be responsible at all.
I think I'm a pretty mild-mannered person. And, you know, I remember after one show, so, you know, some of the guys in, I don't even remember what band were looking at us, like, oh, you guys need anger management. And I was like, no, this is anger management.
When I was younger going to shows, like, I would go, living in New Jersey in the suburbs and being so close to New York, you had this opportunity to be in this normal, like, suburban, you know, lifestyle that was, that was considered the norm of what, you know, America is all about. You know, you just go to school, you know, go to college, get married, have kids, get a job. Every house pretty much looks the same. You do your thing. But then you had a 45-minute train ride into Manhattan where you could see, go, you know, to CBGBs and, you know, see things that you were not seeing in your daily lives at home and be influenced and inspired by all this other stuff. So I remember going into the city without my parents knowing and going to shows and being scared out of my wits, you know, like not knowing what was going to happen. No idea. Like, I just knew I shouldn't be here. Like, my mom would not like me here, you know? And that was a big experience growing up. That was part of what gave me street smarts. That was part of what made me want to inquire about other things and art and music and, like, learn about different cultures and different, you know, classes of people and things that were going on. And so it just, I don't see that anymore. Like, everything is marketed. Everything's contrived. Everything. There's no underground anymore. Everything is just like the first step into becoming like a big band or being on MTV. You know, you could look, go on MTV and figure out how to dress, how to sound, go on the internet, go on YouTube, figure out exactly what to do at a show. Like, if you're watching this band, this is when you put your fist up at this time, because that's when people do it at that part of the song. You know, it's like, that wasn't like that when we first started. And so for us, this has always been like a mission for us to bring that element of unpredictability back in, make you feel uncomfortable. You know, challenge this person, you know, into like being like, I really, not only do we not always know what's going to happen next, but the audience obviously doesn't always know what's going to happen next. And that's kind of what our music is so crazy and frantic. We just want to challenge people into like thinking for themselves.
Stage playing, it's not so much like violence for the sake of, like, you know, being angry, or, you know, it's more like, I feel for me, like, you go out and you show kids that anything is possible, like physical expression, like total lack of inhibition. You know, we go on stage and, you know, it's not, you know, people like doing some contrived moves where, like, we're not jumping up and down at the same time at this part, we're not like, everybody clap for this part, and, you know, you guys wave your hands to the side for that part. They go on stage and it's just 100%, you know, reckless abandon at the same time that people are playing, you know, pretty difficult music, you know. And I feel like for kids, it's more about like showing people that, like, you can do whatever you want, you know, you don't have to be constrained by what people tell you, you know, you have to be constrained by. You can break out of that and you know, somehow become successful playing music that sounds to most people like noise.
I don't think of it as like heavy metal. I'm not playing heavy metal with them. It's an emotion. There's an intensity, you know, there's power and there's anger and there's a lot of stuff that I just want to take out on the world, because the world pisses me off. This world's a joke.
There's aggression involved in it, but it's not just about, it's not about violence. That's the big difference. It's not about violence. It's not about that. It's about cathartic expression and venting. We could bring it from you, but I think this body deserves.